Pulling out onto River Drive in downtown Moline on a stormy Memorial Day, I'm about to cross one more place off my bucket list. Lying in the middle of the mighty Mississippi, historic Rock Island Arsenal is the country's largest and the oldest Army arsenal and the largest employer in the Quad Cities next to John Deere. This was where Dad was assigned for 4 years during my boyhood. We left in 1968 and then we PCS back to Japan. I haven't been back since until now. Dad returned briefly in 71 and 72 to retire and finish out his long and distinguished career serving his country. As I recall, there wasn't a gate here when I was a boy, but times have changed since 9/11.
I've been here since 68.
We got PCS down here in 68.
Yeah,
times have changed. You know, there wasn't a gate here when I was a kid.
Well, God bless you.
Driving down through the heart of the arsenal, I was a boy again. The old Civil War era limestone buildings were still in use.
The United States Army Weapons Command, headquartered at Rock Island, Illinois. An organization with almost two centuries of experience in the art of weaponry. The worldwide mission of the Weapons Command is to develop, produce, and maintain weapons and combat vehicles and their fire control.
It all looked so familiar, as if everything was frozen in time.
For production, and industry can mass produce the weapons the Army needs.
Building 350, this was where Dad worked on a third floor.
Overall supervision of weapons production is the job of the Procurement and Production Directorate at Weapons Command Headquarters. The Production Planning Division has more than 50 industrial engineers and specialists who check on arsenal operation, study new production techniques and modernization programs, and constantly review costs. What you have just seen is the Army Weapons Command today, scientific and industrial pioneers, managers of weapons systems from concept to combat. And above all, they dedicate themselves to the task of providing the soldier in the field with the finest weapons possible.
Among those weapons programs Dad worked on was the Sheridan light tank.
The Sheridan, considered by many to be the greatest advance in combat vehicles since World War II, is an excellent example of what can be accomplished under the project management system. It was conceived here. All new weapons originate in two-dimensional form. And above all, they dedicate themselves to the task of providing the soldier in the field with the finest weapons possible.
As a kid, I was endlessly fascinated by the Arsenal Museum, with the country's largest collection of firearms, most of which was designed right here at Rock Island. Unfortunately, it was closed for Memorial Day. So I stopped by Memorial Field instead, where me and the other boys used to climb and explore the static displays of tanks, howitzers, and big guns. Toward the end of my visit, the dark gray skies finally burst into torrential rains, thunder, and lightning. It was time to leave and pay my final respects at Rock Island National Cemetery on this Memorial Day.